Hello, malty merchandise money grabbers, and thank you to Malt Chronicles for that malt mention. This, malt mates, is Ralfy Review 814 Extras, in which, having reviewed a single malt, I then talk about other things relating to enjoying, appreciating, savouring, and participating in the cult of single malt Scotch whisky and other quality spirits from around the world, because we are a cosmopolitan, international, outward-looking people. We are civilized people on this planet, helping the greater cauldron of humanity. Can I use the word cauldron? Doesn't really work. Does it work? Great big pot, right? Cauldron of humanity, who need the guidance of civil people and some civil company. That's our one of our jobs, malt mates. Now, I'm waving this around, 85, right? Because that's what I've just awarded this single malt as a basic malt mark in Ralfy Review 814. There you are, basic malt. No harm in that. Generally, they can be a bit cheaper. They can certainly be more available. And do you know what? They're a great place to start in your malt journey, because they set you up, basic malts, 40% chill filtered, colour added. They set you up to anticipate and appreciate naturally presented integrity whiskies all the more when you experience them. I guarantee you, when you experience them, you will know the difference immediately. Now, as usual, in the Bothy, I've got my Glencairn glass for the simple reason that they are practical, they're easy to wash, and when you drop them, they're more likely to bounce than break, particularly the older style version of Glencairn glasses, where they had more of a rounded edge at the top of the glass. And this is what I recommend as an affordable. I mean, there's a huge range of glasses out there, but some of them are really pricey and some of them are rather pretentious for what they claim. In my opinion, they don't really deliver. They're a sort of novelty and a kind of collectible item to put in your malt shelf, in your malt space. But we all have a variety of glasses, all of us, in our cupboards. Right. You can see that, oh dear. This one's been above the fireplace, so I should probably have given it a wash first, but there we go. Here is a variety of glassware, and I'm going to recommend that when you take one of your basic single malts that's quite expressive, right, on the nose, put out a cross section of your glassware. And if you want to, you can include coffee mugs, as long as they're properly washed out, and pint mugs, if you want it to be more entertaining. By all means, it's your show, so it's what you decide. So I've taken four glasses here. Is there any other glasses that I've got in the... Got a quake? Not really suitable. That's more for ornament. I'll just go with the four glasses I've got. So I've got a traditional tumbler. I've got my Glencairn. I've got a narrow-necked Kopita and a broad-necked Kopita. Now I'm going to tip them forward so you can see the difference in the apertures of these glasses. And then what I'm going to do, just give it a couple of minutes, have a wee taste of the whisky. Excuse the pun, I'm immersing myself in the experience of this particular single malt I have handy. And that's what you're going to do. You don't even have to use Scotch whisky. It could be bourbon, rye, rum, cognac. But there is so much to be learned about how glasses work. when you nose one glass, you'll smell the liquor. But when you nose another glass, you will smell the liquor differently. What you'll notice is the intensity of the arrival in the nose varies depending on the aperture, depending on the shape of the glass. What you will notice is the priority of smell components. The prioritization will vary between the glasses. So for example, with this Glenlivet, it's an apples and pears type of unpeated, Speyside, slightly sweeter, sweet and sour whiskey. That's what it is, single malt whiskey. But you'll notice that in some glasses, you get more of the apple notes and perhaps a greener melon note. And with other glasses, depending on the shape, the proportions, and the aperture, you will get more of a pear note and banana note or honey note or vanilla note. Now, initially, they won't be that different, really. It's when you give it time, particularly as you develop more experience. It's one of these experiences, take it slow. The slower you go, the further you'll get in the experience. It is fascinating because it's not just the apertures and the shape of the glass you've got to be considering. It's the proportions in the glass. Now, a good glass is basically, you're looking at the bowl, not forget the stem. The stem is really for convenience, for ornamentation, for the comfort of holding it. Looking at the bowl portion, examine it in thirds. Third deep and third across. So if your aperture is one third of the depth of the glass, you will find that is ideal for nosing, and also the shape of the glass. When it's straight up, it displaces the smells in a more haphazard fashion. It becomes more confusing on the nose to focus in and pin down the subtleties of smell. Less so as regards tastes, but taste will be slightly affected, but we're really focusing in smell here, primarily. So when you get a ratioed glass of 1 to 3 parts deep to 1 part across, you've got a great ratio. Now there's 2 parts of that glass is the bowl, 1 part, the top, is the funnel. This works very well. Having said that, it also works with Capita glasses or blender's glasses. They work just as well, very slightly different. You'll notice in this glass, it's 1/3 in the top to 1 to 3, proportion of 1 to 3 as regards the depth to the aperture. We're not being specific, we're being general. Here, smaller glass, narrower neck. This is slightly small for the depth of the glass. It's still competent. But even as you go between these two very similarly shaped glasses and nose between them, you don't just get a slight difference in smell. You get a huge difference in smell. Particularly when you've given it time in the glass to settle down, open up and oxidize a little bit. On the small glass with the narrow aperture, it's much more gummy, confectionery, slightly sweet solventy. On the larger glass with the wider aperture, and sure, it's actually got less volume, so you might want to use a pre-poured measure for anorak accuracy. Slight, more floral, definitely. Lily, daffodil, apple, slightly russet apple, no banana, oak, getting oak wood now, much more oak pronounced than this glass. It's a fascinating experience, and it's great fun when you've got your mates round, because if you're in a budget, right? If you're in a budget and you're limited with access to the spirits you can buy and afford, and you're particularly if you've started the journey, it is such great fun to just, all you need is one bottle of liquor, because everybody has got more than one shape of glass in their kitchen. And I'm talking about tumblers. Most folk have got tumblers. These are not expensive glasses. They're really not. Sure, you can get wumblers and you can get glasses with little bumps inside that help with the swirling. They're expensive. I don't buy them. I don't use them. If you like the idea and you've got the budget, check it out. No harm done. It's entirely up to yourself. But these four are just simple, accessible, available glassware that you can find where you are. They won't cost you a fortune. And for a budget malt moment with mates, this is just such great fun. It's been years, by the way, it's been about 10 years, not quite, but we're getting there, since I actually reviewed glassware for whisky. So it's nice to come back to it in a more fun perspective, because you'll probably notice now and again I get a bit grumpy here in the Bothy, and I basically become a green-faced old farty. Now, I admit it, I do, because occasionally, malt mates, I am an old farty, but never a smelly old farty. That's important. And importantly, never be an old farty for too long. Get back to the positivity. Get back to become more malt Jedi than malt Sith. That's important. Anyway, I'm Ralphie. I think that'll do for this malt moment. 814 extras. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you found it entertaining, informational, informative, and malt-ertaining. I'm Ralphie. You take care now, and remember, even if you're not sober, act sober, be sober, think sober, do sober, because when you look around you at people who get too pished too often, their life generally is heading in the wrong direction. Don't malt mates, and I'm just telling you, so as you know, I'm just saying, don't let it be you.